Running shoes have evolved pretty fast. They are lighter, they are faster, and they are bouncier. Indeed, a lot of man hours and technological innovation have enabled brands with so much performance into such tiny pieces of foam so that you and I can run more, faster, and with less effort. Even more importantly, we get more comfort and less likelihood of injuries. This video will help you understand your running shoes more so you can make better informed choices on your next purchase. And of course, appreciate those that make them. When watching running shoe reviews, you commonly hear things like EVA, TPE, TPEE, PEBA, supercritical, and so on. And many people do not fully grasp what is being said. So that's what I'll be breaking down today so that you can have a clearer picture of what's being said. And not just that, it can also help you choose better when you understand the material. The power of your running shoes lies in the midsole, and most importantly, the foam. Basically, a foam is a substance formed by trapping gas bubbles inside a liquid or solid. Any foam that you have, even the one you sleep on, gas is trapped inside a solid. A large proportion of the materials is occupied by gas. When it comes to running shoes, there are basically three materials that are commonest for their foams. The EVA, TPU, and the latest one, PEBA. Of course, there are thousands of variations of this. That's why each shoe has its own unique characteristics. To make this cushioned and lightweight, manufacturers inject gas using what is called a blowing agent to create tiny bubbles inside the material. This process is called foaming. Now, the size, the density, and structure of these gas bubbles, of course, as well as some additives, you know, like linkages that they also add, are what determines the shoe's characteristics such as flexibility, cushioning, responsiveness, and durability. Tweaking the manufacturing process, like temperature and pressure, and material compositions too, lead to variations in the foams and ultimately the shoe's performance characteristics during a run. That's why you can have 100 shoes with EVA foam with 100 different characteristics, you know. But the ultimate running shoe foaming technology right now is called supercritical foaming. You will hear that a lot in running shoe reviews, especially racing shoes. Today, we'll be breaking it all down. So let's talk about how shoe foams evolved over time. You know, first, there was EVA. EVA stands for ethylene vinyl acetate. EVA consists of two polymers, the ethylene half and the vinyl acetate. Ethylene brings the strength, while the vinyl acetate brings the elasticity and softness. So you see that tweaking the ratio of these polymers during the manufacturing process will also go a long way to affect the final foam's characteristics. That's why you can have 50 running shoes with EVA foams all feel different underfoot. EVA dominated running shoes for quite a long period. And even today, it's still the commonest foam that you are going to find in running shoes. The reason is because it's cheap, it's easy to mold, and it's relatively lightweight also. It offers a decent cushion and is durable. So it's easy for manufacturers to use this and make a lot of shoes, especially the cheaper ones. Then next came the TPU. TPU stands for thermoplastic polyurethane. TPU is a highly versatile material that combines the best properties of plastic and rubber. It is flexible and elastic like rubber. It is durable and moldable like plastic. It offers better shock absorption, has a higher energy return, and it is more durable than the EVA also. But of course, it is heavy. It is the heaviest of the three basic materials that you use in foam. It's heavier than EVA and PEBA. When you think of OG TPU midsole, think of the Adidas Boost. Then there are variations in the TPU also. That's where you now get the TPE and the TPEE. You know, TPE simply stands for thermoplastic elastomer. You know, this material is just a blend of rubber and plastic. And then you have the TPEE, the thermoplastic polyester elastomer. This one is also another fantastic material that a lot of modern racing shoes are using. That's the material you have in one of my favorite racing shoes, the Quaidon Plate 1 and the 1.5. The TPEE is a blend of polyester and elastomer. But then finally came the game changer, the PEBA. PEBA simply stands for polyester block amide. This material is super light, resilient, and delivers fantastic energy return. In fact, it took the running world by storm. That's what powers shoes like the Vaporfly, the Alphafly. You might also hear about PEBAGS. PEBAGS is simply a brand name for a family of PEBA-based foams also. It's widely used in racing shoes today because of its unique combination of lightweight, cushion, and bounce. So you see that each foam was a step forward, you know, in more energy return, more comfort, faster running. But brands were not even done yet. They wanted more control. They wanted better. And that's where supercritical foaming entered the race. You know, you hear this a lot in running shoe reviews, especially racing shoes. People are always talking about supercritical foam. People always ask me, is this supercritical? Is this, what is supercritical? What does it actually mean? Now, a supercritical fluid is what you get when you heat a gas beyond a certain temperature at very high pressure. Beyond a certain point called the critical point, what you get is something strange. It is not fully gas. It is not fully liquid, but it now has a property of both. It can dissolve substances like a liquid, and it can penetrate substances like a gas. When you use it in shoe foam production, you get insane control over how the bubbles are formed inside the foam. Here's how it works. You start with a block of raw material. It may be PEBA, TPU, TPE, TPEE. You now expose this to supercritical carbon dioxide or nitrogen under intense pressure and heat. The supercritical gas gets absorbed deep inside the material. Then they rapidly reduce pressure and boom, the gas expands into millions of uniform microcells inside the material. The resulting foam is then cooled and molded into the midsole. Because the resulting microcells is so evenly spaced, you know, similar sized, the final product is softer, springier, and lighter. And in some cases, even more durable than traditional foams. So the next time you hear supercritical foaming in a running shoe, that's exactly what they are talking about. Most popular brands, you know, use supercritical foaming these days, especially in their racing shoes. Of course, the Nike ZoomX is PEBA-based supercritical foam. The Saucony PowerRun PB is also PEBA-based supercritical foam, which they use in their endorphin lines. The Puma Nitro Elite is nitrogen-infused EVA or TPU. In fact, one of the shoes that I reviewed last, the Equiadon Plate 2.0, now have a supercritical PEBA. Of course, each brand tweaks the chemistry and different materials to get the final blend of what they really want. That's where the race really is, and that's where each shoe feels different. Of course, all EVA are not the same. All PEBA are not the same. You know, that's why ZoomX in the Vaporfly is different from ZoomX in the Vomero, because they tweak a few physical properties during the foaming process. So what does this mean for you as a runner? It means more comfort, more energy return, faster times, longer runs, less injuries. Supercritical foams have helped bet the super shoe evolution. Without them, there's no sub 2-hour marathon. So in the end, it's not just chemistry, it's speed science. Of course, this is not all uhuru. You know, there are a few downsides to this. The most important one is this is an expensive process. That's why most of these shoes are very expensive. You know, think of all of them, the Vaporflies, the Alphaflies, the Adios Pros, you know, Endorphin Elites. But technology keeps evolving. Brands keeps experimenting with new ideas, new foams, new mixtures, new everything, you know. So I still believe that we are still scratching the surface. In summary, the foaming process have changed the way we run, all thanks to a little gas, a lot of heat, and some brilliant minds in the lab. I hope this video has been at least a little informative for you. Thanks for watching, by the way. Do not forget to like and subscribe if you gained anything from this video. And until the next one is goodbye.